there. Good to see you. We have a new home, the glorious Gladstone Pottery Museum. I have been dusting off the potter's wheel and disinfecting everything. Keith has even washed his hankies. And I am now new head of social distancing. Actually, get back. Yeah. Do you know what? We can get a little bit closer because the potters, the judges, and moi have been living in a bubble 24/7 here in Stoke. Morning, judges.
Morning.
What can possibly go wrong? Whoa, sorry, Rose. Welcome to the new series of The Great Pottery Throwdown. We've searched across the country to find 12 of the nation's finest home potters.
My family said, you should really go for it. Now I'm actually here, I'm like, oh my goodness, now I actually have to do it.
One thing I have learned is unless you go for it, nothing's gonna change. So I'm just going for it.
Oh God, okay, nervous.
To save this year's Great Pottery Throwdown, they've agreed to leave their loved ones to live and work together in our very own potter's bubble.
As a potter, very often you're working on your own, whereas here you've got people to bounce ideas off and there's so much energy.
Each week, they'll be asked to transform lumps of clay into unique and beautiful ceramics.
I'm quite nervous now, but just sit me at that wheel and the stresses all disappear.
Sometimes you just sit at the wheel, you connect it, everything works. You never know.
Everything they conjure up will be judged by maverick master potter, Keith Brymer-Jones.
Well, obviously, this has been a bit of a year. I just wonder if I'm going to get even more emotional than ever before, because it does feel like a real family.
You've done really, really well.
My father said, make sure you make him cry. I was like, I don't want to make anyone cry, thank you, because that'll make me cry.
And this year we have a new judge, our former studio technician, ceramics expert, Rich Miller.
I've been working with clay now for over 20 years and I absolutely love it. It's malleable, it's tactile, it can be made into any form. And then you've got the alchemy of the fire. And what's not to love about it?
So are these potters ready?
How are you feeling, Sal?
Terrifying.
The most stressful thing I've ever done.
For 20 brand new challenges.
Can I touch it?
No.
Bit of age, bit of experience, bit of calmness.
Quickly, quickly, hurry up! And who will go on to be named champion?
Oh my God.
I'm speechless.
And if you don't stop asking me questions, I might cry again.
Of the Great Pottery Throwdown.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna have a problem.
Are we gonna stop there? No.
Back in Stoke-on-Trent, the home of British pottery, and we've rolled our wheels and clay into the Gladstone Pottery Museum, a once bustling manufacturer of chinaware in the heart of the city. Our 12 potters will kickstart the competition with two throwing challenges, after which our judges, Keith and Rich, will decide who'll be our first potter of the week and who will leave the pottery. Good morning, potters!
Morning!
Good morning! Look at your faces! Look at you all full of hope. Won't last long. Don't worry, it's my first day as well, so we'll get through this together. Now, the judges for your very first challenge would like you to make a cheese set. That must include a cheese dome with a sculptured knob, a fondue pot, and two identical pickle jars with lids.
It's a throwing challenge, the first challenge, right up my street. And it's a domestic ware. It's got to be fit for purpose.
Form and measurements are critical in this challenge. You've got to leave enough space under your dome for your cheese, and we want to see really well-fitting lids on those pickle jars.
The judges have very generously given you 3 hours to make your cheese set, and your time starts now.
This is like my dream to be here. So whatever happens, I've got to this stage, it's all good.
A little bit nervous about throwing. I think I just a couple of minutes of just getting into it and not to be like
Before they can begin, the potters must wedge the clay, a kneading process that removes any air bubbles. Then they'll have 3 hours to throw their cheese set on the wheel and then another 90 minutes to trim any excess clay and refine every item.
Very excited and out of breath. I could have done a bit more cardio before I came here.
So here we are, week one. I'm really, really excited.
And it's a tough challenge. I mean, the cheese dome, that's quite a big thing to throw on the wheel. I mean, if they don't get that curve right and get that beautifully domed shape, there's not going to be sufficient volume under there to contain all that cheese.
And that dome has to fit really snugly on top of that plate. When they think about the fondue pot, that base has to be nice and flat so that heat can circulate evenly underneath it. They're domestic ware, they have to work.
Good clean rims, all of those points that your hand comes into contact with have to be beautiful and pristine. But I guess I'm really keen to see how they use their design to really draw them all together as a set and make them feel like they're meant to be together.
Morning, Jodie.
Morning.
Or should I say Borada?
Borada. Thank you for having me.
Has anyone ever told you you look like
Alanis Morissette?
Well,
all the time.
Wales is Alanis Morissette.
Yeah, pretty much.
Imagine how good your voice is then.
Oh, it's not very good.
give us.
You can make a fortune.
No, I'm not giving you nothing.
Can you tell us a bit about your cheese set design?
So it was about a trip that I took to America with my father. We went on the motorbikes.
Jodie is from the Rhondda Valley, and when she isn't working as a scrub nurse, she hits the road as much as possible with her dad, Colin.
Happy days.
Her cheese set will celebrate their gracious road trip along Route 66.
So my decoration is based on these red canyons, and I'm going to have the actual dark desert highway going into the canyons. So,
dark desert highway.
On a dark desert highway.
Yeah, it's a good song.
Come on, there's a song out of you one way or the other. Lee's hobbies are perhaps a little less thrill-seeking.
I decided to do my theme based on beekeeping. So those are my bees.
Wow. They take after you.
Do you think?
Yeah, I can see the resemblance.
Yeah.
Lee is a community nurse, and as well as his bees, he lives in Huddersfield with his rescue dog, Margot, and his tortoise, Reg.
Bit of salad.
His set will feature handcrafted bees on a classic hive-shaped cheese dome.
And that contouring of the cheese dome, are you throwing that in?
Partly.
Right, OK.
I am going to throw it thickly and then trim the butt off it.
Right.
Okay. So I'm not concerned. Right. I'm not worried.
Keep on running. Keep on hiding.
Throwing the cheese dome involves wrestling around 5 kilograms of clay.
I'm very hot, very hot. This is the largest piece.
Okie dokie, I just need to check the depth.
It starts life upside down as a bowl, and the potters need to pull the clay up to shape what will be the curved sides of the dome. The higher they go, the more space for the cheese.
It needs to come up just a little bit more.
But throwing at this scale is always a gamble.
Well, the risk is now it gets too thin, the clay's too wet, and it'll collapse.
Oh, it's gone, it's gone.
One dead pot.
Married mum of three, Suze, is a library assistant and lives in Aberdeenshire. She has been potting for 16 years and hopes to be able to combine her love of books and clay by retelling the classic Treasure Island through the forms and decorations of her cheese set.
These are lovely little drawings.
Yes.
Really nice.
So I'm hoping to have the pirates and then a skull and crossbones for the sculptural knob.
It looks like there's a lot of decorative work here. Is there going to be time to get everything in?
Okay.
I think that sounds confident. Yes, I'm willing to go with that. Yeah. While Suze has had to start her cheese dome all over again...
Right, Susan, just think.
She's not the only one daunted by the dome.
It's got the wobble. Could fall off my stool any minute because I do forget to breathe.
Adam is a support worker for adults with learning difficulties and lives in Brighton with his fiancée, Dan, and their pug, Egg. He will celebrate their trips out to sea with a maritime cheese dome complete with a diving whale.
Dodgy dome number one, sac magique.
Even if the potters think their domes are large enough to satisfy the judges,
come back. Oh, bugger.
This first make gets even trickier. Every dome must sit on a matching plate, and one potter plans to dish up something very close to their heart.
My design is based on a beach where I used to live. Me and my friends, we used to eat together on this beach.
Henry now lives in Suffolk. When he isn't honing his circus skills, he works as an activities organiser for a retirement home. He aims to throw a set that reflects the contrasting textures of his favourite coastal dinner spot.
How are you going to bring this into your cheese set design?
There's going to be some of the pots that are unglazed, so they have this really rocky, brutal texture. Then this lovely blue glaze hits up against it, so you get the contrast of the two. I've got the best memories of that place.
Dinner hasn't been the same since.
It's never been the same since.
Perfectly matched plates and domes are just for starters.
Going fondue potty.
The bottom of the fondue set is thicker than you'd normally have it because it has to withstand heat.
But to serve fondue, every pot will need a handle.
The only times I've ever had fondue have been when you go skiing and then you just eat your body weight in cheese. Oh, I'm hungry.
Shen Yu is a professional model working and living in London with her boyfriend, Alex. Her cheese set is inspired by her favourite moments from their last holiday together.
I'm bad at skiing. My boyfriend's amazing at skiing. We've only been once and we're probably not going again, but... So then I look forward to the dinner the most.
Yeah.
You're in the Alps and there's the beautiful moon and the stars.
And that's when the fondue comes out.
That's when the fondue comes out, yeah. Almost like a cauldron of fondue.
Between two people.
You never finish the cheese and those things.
Well, I beg to differ.
I beg to differ, yes.
Potters, don't get yourself in a pickle, but you are now halfway through your challenge. Oh! Good woman, Suze is coming, finally!
Small start. Gotta get better.
As Suze finally moves on from the giant cheese dome...
I'm just starting on my pickle jars now.
For everyone else, throwing just got a whole lot more intricate. Keith and Rich have asked for two identically formed pickle jars.
I've measured everything out because if they want identical things, it's crucial that you get everything weighing the same before you even start.
I've been religiously measuring it with my ruler.
Pickle jars are supposed to be matching. They could be sisters, not twins.
Irina's jars could be of interest to Lee's bees.
These roses are gonna be my nobs. Roses, my favorite things.
Originally from far eastern Russia, Irina now lives in Essex, and when she's not at work for a private jet company, she obsesses over the roses in her garden and her kiln. They'll dominate a set with a ruffle-edged plate and surfaces hand-painted with rose bush stalks and leaves.
In Russia, only hardy roses can grow because the climate. It's very harsh winter. So when I came to the UK, I felt like paradise. I got, like, if I'm not lying, four bushes of the same rose. I'm not really a super professional making jar lids. Hopefully it will be similar. Oh, I can't be engineer. Definitely not.
My father was an engineer, my grandfather was an engineer, and because I was awarded a place at art school, it didn't mean I was going to art school. He decided that I was going to be an engineer, and I applied for an engineering apprenticeship at Hoover's in Perivale, massive Art Deco building.
Peter's engineering career lasted 30 years, but he's now returned to his first love, to become a design and technology teacher, a passion he shares with his 10 grandchildren.
What about this, Shanti? What do you think of that?
Out of 100, I'd give it 33.
Oh.
His pickle jars and his cheese dome will be decorated with Art Deco features from the iconic Hoover building.
Art Deco is all about those sort of clean lines. How are you sort of planning to bring that precision into your make?
So, I've designed these sprigs, and then I'm going to sculpt my sculptured lady.
Wow.
Look at her.
Well, not actually her, clearly.
No, no.
You know, mine's going to have a much larger bottom, I can tell you. You
know? Modelled on me, isn't it? Family and art will also come together for Hannah's set.
My granddad was a painter, and they're based on a painting that my granddad did. Here's a really awful printout of the painting.
Hannah works as a housing project manager and lives in Bristol. Her granddad, Tim, has been a source of inspiration since she was little. And her favourite painting by him has inspired a cheese set that has simple forms but bold, colourful decoration.
The design reminds me a bit of Patrick Heron, the painter down in Cornwall.
Is.
Yeah.
Okay.
That wasn't your granddad, was it?
No. Oh, I wish not. I don't know if many people knew who he was, sadly.
Potters, you have 1 hour left.
Not going to have everything finished at this rate.
Having had time to dry, the cheese sets are now leather hard and the potters must refine them. trimming away excess clay to enhance the shape and finish of their pots before getting them into the drying room, ready for the first firing.
This is the fun bit, yeah.
Is this the fun
bit? Yeah, yeah.
Can I touch it?
No.
Okay. But some potters aren't trimming away clay to a smooth profile.
I'm going to trim it and then add, like, the bumpy grooves, like an old-fashioned beehive.
I'm taking the raking that happens in a Zen garden and I'm going to carve that into each piece.
Ara lives in Folkestone, a retired West End theatre wardrobe manager. He accessorizes his ceramic sculptures. But his Zen garden cheese set will be a simpler affair, harmonised with repeated patterns, all enhanced with a pure white glaze.
I really like concentric circles, the geometry, the sharpness of it.
But Alon doesn't seem to be a fan of refining a perfect circle.
I knew everyone would make something circular, so I sort of wanted to just try to be a bit different, to change it up.
At 20 years old, Alon is this year's youngest potter. Raised in Israel, he now lives with his family in London and is an architecture student. His square cheese set will feature a motif of unique family roots.
All my family has different names from nature.
Oh, really?
The middle sister is Hadar, which means citrus. The older sister is Nitzan, which means bud.
Yeah. That's beautiful.
Lovely. My name in Hebrew means oak, and acorns could be great knobs. So, yeah.
What? Sorry, what?
Acorns could be great knobs.
Is that your dog, Sally?
Yeah.
What was he called again?
Charlie.
Oh.
Instead of throwing knobs for my pickle pots, I thought I'll sculpt little Charlie's, and he loves cheese. Cheddar, camembert, brie, goat's cheese, Stilton.
Sal is a teacher and lives in Cornwall with her partner Hazel and their dogs Fred and cheese-loving Charlie.
I haven't got nothing. All the cheese has gone.
He will stand guard on top of her pickle jars and cheese dome, and Sal will use fine brushwork and glaze to draw him running around her set. Isn't he lovely?
Thank you very much.
And his little cheese.
Yeah.
Oh, he eats a lot of cheese, doesn't he?
He does, actually. Well, it's the only way to get him to do anything he's told. Bribery works a treat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm open to a bit of bribery, by the way. Yeah.
Okay, later.
Yeah, just letting you know. Right. Potters, you have half an hour left. Half an hour.
So I'm just trying to sculpt my queen bee as quick as I can.
I've got to sculpt three ladies.
This is the knob for the dome. This is like the centerpiece that I'm gonna have to do in about 5 minutes. I've got my spoon, everything's okay. My favorite tool, I'm trying to make like a rock archway. I mean, I nicked it from the kitchen. My mum still doesn't know that this is where it is. So she'll find out now and be hopefully not too angry, but probably very angry.
I'm pressing as hard as I dare, but there she is in place.
Even if their domes are complete, there is even more complex refining to do.
Oh, so close.
The lid to every pickle jar must be trimmed to fit perfectly.
You've got to take into account the shrinkage rate of the clay from when it's wet to when it's dry, and from when it's dry to when it's fired as well.
Should fit in like that, but it doesn't really.
There we go.
Potters, it is now 5 minutes to go.
I'm going to work to the wires, just keep going.
Put a little bit of that on there, a little bit of that on there, and then put them together. And the trick is to wiggle until it won't wiggle anymore.
We are talking about the last 2 minutes now, people. Last 2 minutes. Welcome, congratulations, Sal. First item into the drying room. How are we doing? We're nearly there. That's a good sculpt. Quickly! Good man, Peter. That's a determined walk. In you go.
Thank you.
Oh, fabulous. Okay, quickly, back to your benches. That is your very first day finish. Congratulations.
All calm at the end of the day. I tell you what, I'm going to have a glass of wine tonight.
Oh, too bloody right.
The potters now face an agonising wait. Once they're completely dry, our new studio technician, Rose, will take the cheese sets for their first bisque firing, which will harden the clay so that it's ready for decoration.
So it's the petals of Irina's flowers that have me worried. You can already see that there's a chance that there will be some breaking there.
If you look for the whole set from the distance, I think it's okay. And the knobs feels like going your hand nicely on all of the pieces.
Yeah, I'm really worried about the thickness of Susie's pieces. You would put your lids together to have them shrink together. These lids are also quite thick. That might mean that there's still a lot of difference between the shrinking of the lids and the actual pot.
Obviously, I lost a lot of time throwing the dome. There's the chance of things blowing up or cracks appearing. It's in the hands of the kiln gods.
The potters will now have to wait to discover if their sets survive the 1,000-degree heat of the kiln without cracking or even exploding.
Fingers crossed.
Each week, the potters will face a second challenge. They'll never know what they'll be asked to make, but this week, it could go rather well with their cheese sets. Welcome to your second challenge, which is a throwdown, and we would like you to make port chalices. Okay. Master Potter Keith, if you would like to take to your wheel.
Right, port chalices, basically another word for goblet. Shove it on the wheel. Center it up, lift your hands up just slightly off the wheel, and you create your base. Start making the cup when the stem is quite thick still, because you've got that support of the stem to really shape your cup nice and fine. And then throw up that stem so it's nice and fluent. Rib up the side and really accentuate that form.
Amazing.
Finesse that stem. Make it a bit narrower, and then I'm literally just going to re-center it a bit. So it's growing out of that stem.
It's so beautiful.
Tidy up the rim, and then wire it off. And there you go. We're looking for quantity, but as well, we're looking for quality.
Potters, you have 15 minutes to make as many chalices as possible.
Oh.
And your time starts now.
Really difficult. I'm not that quick at centering, and it's all about centering quickly.
I can't even remember how you did the first bit.
No hanging about.
Take your time.
But hurry up.
I don't want to make a rubbish chalice, but also I want to make more than one.
I think I should be able to get myself 7, 8, I don't know.
So how many do you think you'd be able to throw in 15 minutes?
12, 13.
Yeah, me too.
The most stressful thing I've ever done.
Irina's got one off.
She's got one already. Ah, what's happening?
It's terrifying. Oh, I've made one. That's good.
Oh, wow. You've two done already.
They're not very good, though.
Come on, Jodie. Excellent. Some people have two done already.
No way.
How are we doing, Henry?
I'm struggling.
Well done, Adam.
Oh, thanks.
And they all want to be similar.
Ooh.
Good stuff, Peter. They're in the same family, little and large. 5 minutes gone, 10 minutes left.
What? It took me 5 minutes to do one.
How many now, Lee?
Two and a half.
You've got to do it right, but you've got to do it quickly. I can't seem to get both of those things at the same time.
It's so difficult to get that balance, isn't it, between form and speed.
That is terrible. That's going to go in the bin.
I know, my right leg's starting to shake now.
Oh, here we go. Oh, oh. That's a nice sound. What are we doing? Oh, look, it's doing a little bit.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my gosh. Shen Yu has 6.
No way.
Don't want to make the rest of you feel bad, but you're doing dreadfully in comparison.
Sal's looking very accurate.
Yeah, nice, yeah. Remember, the speed of the wheel is important.
The what?
The speed of the wheel.
The speed of the wheel is important.
You sound like an expert, then.
I sound like an expert.
Oh, dear.
We are in the last 5 minutes. Who needs me to scream at them to encourage them more?
All of us.
Hurry up! Quickly! Quickly! Quickly!
That's brilliant advice.
Last couple of minutes.
Oh, my life.
It so helps if you breathe in while you're doing it.
Focus, Jodie, focus.
Last minute, everybody.
Oh, I've got it all over me.
Come on, kid.
Oh, OK.
Finish that one and start a new one. And make it your best one.
Yeah, this is going to be the best one.
Oh, I've lost my wire.
Five, four, three, two, one. Step away from the wheel, please. Well,
oh, my God, look at
The Potters will now face the judges for the very first time.
Oh, my gosh.
Keith and Rich are looking for chalices with a distinct stem, cup, and smooth rim. Any that don't measure up, we recycle into Keith's bucket of doom.
Hi, Jodie.
Hi, Jodie.
Wow. We've got plenty to look at here.
We have got plenty to look at.
Fairly similar, which is good. This one's a little bit shorter.
Yeah, yeah, that's got to go.
Oh!
There's a couple of fat stems.
That's not great. I mean, look at the state of that one.
A little bit screwed.
Are we going to stop there? No. I think that has to go as well. But what I'm really noticing is the consistency of the rim. They are all roughly the same thickness. That's not bad. Fantastic.
They're looking wonderful.
You've managed to get a really nice, even rim on all of them. It's very consistent. You've upped the ante in the shape and the form, so there's a couple there that aren't up to your standards.
This is it.
Although it's slightly slanting, it's really well proportioned. Yeah. But this one here, that's going in the bin.
Oh.
But, I mean, that is a great set.
You can see the elephant in the room. This...
Tipping it over.
This one, yeah. Oh. Yeah. Look, it's even crying.
I know. I almost am.
There's not much base to this one. It's quite a fat stem. Yeah. But the cup is beautiful.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to save that one, but get rid of that one. Oh. Not enough definition in the stem. You were obviously really concentrating on that first one, and then you kind of were rushing the...
I was going for quality. I was going for...
Were you really?
Yes, I was going for...
The definition between the stem and the cup wasn't great.
OK.
I think that one.
Yeah, no, that's not good.
We're doing this to me.
What's really interesting is that the rims are nice and thin.
There's definitely a finesse there. Yeah, I just wonder about
there's some
about
lovely...
This.
Let's get rid of that. Well, there's definitely a style there, isn't there?
Yeah, a more angular cup to it.
This has hardly got a stem at all.
Yeah, I already say goodbye to that one.
Yeah, that's a bit hopeless.
OK.
That's going... I think we can stop there.
I think that's grand, actually. I think we can keep going. We can keep going, yeah.
I already created names for each of them.
Oh, go on.
Tanya, Sveta, Irina, Natasha, Svetlana, Alena, Marina, and this one, Sarah. And then this one, Margarita.
Wow. Of course. Yeah, well, Margarita can go.
I'm not sure about Sarah either.
Poor old Sarah.
She's the worst
Sarah. I mean, some of the bases are a little bit thin, like this one here is starting to crack.
Well, we're going to have to get rid of that, I think. That one is...
Which one?
No.
I like you, how you try to hide them.
It's hopeless. This one, the definition isn't brilliant.
No.
This is wonderful.
It's a good one. Should we talk about the others?
It's absolutely terrible.
That was my last 10-second run.
This one looks like me after a couple of ports.
Oh, right. OK. Yeah, that's going to have to go, I think.
I think it's got to go.
Yeah, yeah. That's got to go.
Wow.
And that's got to go.
Ouch. Fair play. I thought you were just going to sweep them all.
No. It's definitely quantity here. Well, there is at the moment. This one isn't brilliant definition.
Yeah, you need a very definite voice.
So we'll have to get rid of that one. That's not a great look.
No stem. My eye just keeps being drawn to this one.
Well, let's just take that one away then as well. Shall we stop there?
I think so. I think that's fair.
Maybe after that one.
No!
And I think we can stop there. They could have been slightly taller. They're not perfect by any stretch, but I can really appreciate the consistency in them, and I'm kind of loath to throw any of them away.
I think they look great.
Well done.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Keith and Rich will now rank the Potter's chalices from the worst set to the best.
In 12th place, with 4 chalices, is Henry.
Peter, Ara, Hannah, Lee, and Suze each threw 5 chalices. Adam, Irina, and Alon threw 6. And with Sal, Shen Yu, and Jody all throwing 8, the judges will rank these top 3 on the quality of their throwing.
In 3rd place, Shen Yu. In 2nd place, Jody. 1st place, Sal.
Thank you.
Well done, Sal. Well done. Brilliant.
Thank you so much, guys.
Really good.
Thank you.
Well done, all of you.
Well done, everyone.
Brilliant.
It's 20 years of learning how to do it, and all of a sudden somebody says, yeah, all right, you're pretty good at that. It's kind of awesome. And if you don't stop asking me questions, I might cry again.
It's day 2 of the main make, and after a 24-hour firing, the cheese sets are ready to be decorated. But the potters won't know if their work has survived the intense heat of the kiln until they remove the hessian.
I think we're all feeling a bit vulnerable today, maybe.
Have I got intact pieces?
Worst case scenario, the sprigs are blown off. The dough might not come out. The sculptures have fallen off.
The jars might snap off.
I hope there will be something to decorate.
Good morning, potters. Now, your cheese sets have been bisque-fired and they're hiding under the hessian, so hopefully no cracks or broken knobs.
We'd like to see you enhance your pieces and really bring your cheese sets together.
This is a domestic ware challenge, so these have to be user-friendly. Think about the areas that you're glazing, but also think about the areas you're not glazing.
You have 2.5 hours to decorate your cheese sets. Potters, your time starts now.
Yeah! The little dance.
Just to see the piece not broken is so overwhelming. Absolutely overwhelming. I try to hold my tears back.
But while some might be relieved to find intact forms and functioning pots, Alan's round lids don't quite fit his square jars.
Maybe. Come on.
And he's not alone.
I might have to top it. No. It's getting glazed in place.
But to begin decorating, the first substance the potters need to apply to their cheese sets isn't glaze.
First job is to put wax resist on all of the bits that I don't want to get glazed on.
As well as decoration, the wax is also a crucial substance for function.
The dome is fired together, so you have to keep the glazes separate.
So this shiny bit is wax resist. The dome will go on top, the wax resist will burn away, and the dome shouldn't, fingers crossed, stick to the plate.
Otherwise, I'll have a cheese dome with no way getting the cheese in.
No way getting the cheese out. An actual nightmare.
The potters are free to use any of the glazes available in the studio. But in ceramics, all is not what it seems.
I got a feeling the tutu tango isn't going to be very tango.
Glazes can radically change colour in the heat of the kiln.
You never know exactly how it's going to be. I'm going in completely blind.
And Jodie's dark desert highway could end up lighter than she and her dad remembered.
I really hope it comes out orange. Peach canyons. So this is Monument Valley. So you can see the orange canyons contrasting with the blue sky. So that's something I've incorporated into my design. So hopefully I'll be able to capture
a bit of depth to them
so they just look a bit more alive rather than just like a flat painting.
But a flat painting is at the heart of Hannah's design.
My granddad's paintings are all over my parents' house. It was very inspiring. Extremely chilled guy, and I don't want to plan it out too much.
Irina and Sal, however,
writing on the curved surface is interesting,
are taking the time to plan every brush stroke.
Opposite the handle is my halfway spot, so I wrote this one forwards and then started at the halfway and wrote this one backwards. And I'm dyslexic, but that's ridiculous.
Suze has managed to come up with a design that requires more preparation than anyone else's.
Palm trees, desert islands, pirates going around the side, treasure map, and the jars to be painted to look like wooden barrels. So, a lot to do.
Lee's preparation should be a little more straightforward.
Need a bigger brush.
But he will have to coat every inch of his beehive set in multiple layers of glaze.
Coat number two.
To make it look like it's been smothered in honey.
Just to get the sheer volume of it all on. I'm literally using a paintbrush from home.
Oh,
yeah.
Arrow will be even more reliant on just one colour.
Look, everything's going to be dipped in white because I'm hoping the grooves will actually do the work for me with the light and shadow and stuff like that.
OK, so that's just going to have a white glaze on it?
Yeah, my gut says just go for it.
Simple but effective.
Hopefully.
A bit like me. Quite frankly.
Oh, I don't know.
Potters, you have 1 hour remaining for your decoration.
It runs away with you, doesn't it? At the time, it's just like, what?
I do enjoy glazing, and especially brush on glazes. I think it's very personal.
I've got to draw my Charlies. When I paint them, it won't just be flat grey. I'll use maybe 4 or 5 different greys and sort of try and create some texture and some life in his coat.
But something even more lifelike has washed up on Treasure Island.
Is that meant to be Rich?
Yes.
We have Keith here.
And this must be... What am I doing?
That's
I'm holding, holding a barrel.
I thought we were friends.
I thought we were the
stripy sisterhood.
Well, I thought you should be in on the art.
Well, do you know what? I cannot believe I'm being immortalised in a cheese set. I mean, bring the list. I have something to cross off my bucket list.
Having just about got away with squared forms...
It's manganese, so super toxic. Woo.
Alan is taking an even bigger risk with his decoration by mixing glaze with metal oxides.
What have you got on the go there?
So this has got a lot of manganese, a bit of copper and a bit of cobalt.
If carefully mixed in with glazes during the final firing, metal oxides can create some of the most unpredictable but spectacular colours in ceramics.
What's it got in it? Manganese, you're saying?
It's got manganese, like 60-something percent.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a lot of manganese.
So where are you putting this?
On the acorns. Quite risky, because it could turn out bronzy gold, which is the ideal, but it also could go very dark brown.
So how do you think that's going to interact with the other glazes? You hopefully they'll be...
No idea. We'll see. This is a glaze I've never tried before.
That's a bold move.
Yeah.
Week one, good place to try it out.
I know.
No pressure?
No pressure at all.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have half an hour left.
Oh, my God.
It's not a problemo.
Not only do the potters have to complete their decorations, as these are homeware pieces, to be functional, every item must also be coated in a second clear glaze.
That glossiness is so you can wash it. None of your food is going to soak into that clay.
But transparent glaze doesn't start life clear. It's used to coat all their decorative work, which means the potters won't know if it succeeded until it's been fired. But for some, a final glaze will have to wait.
It's the finessing. You shouldn't rush. You've got to get a face on.
I've cut out some stencily things. So I've got some blobby stuff, but then I've also got some sharp stencils on top.
That's an atomizer. So I put half and half mix of water glaze, and I sprayed it over the stencil, so I'll get the dusk till dawn kind of thing, you know? I think I saw it in a craft shop. I was like, that's brilliant.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have a problem.
Things aren't going so brilliantly for Ara.
The glaze is a bit too thick. If I don't get the stuff out that I've put in can actually disappear under the thick glaze.
Big blob in the middle.
Oh my God, that's terrible. But I'll have to do because I've got to move on.
What's the time?
10 minutes left. Hurry up, Irina, get those flower petals.
I'm pushing it now, and I've got 10 of these to do, so...
Oh, looking good. Quickly, quickly. Oh, no! How are we doing, Peter?
Bottom's nearly waxed.
We've got a wet bottom here. We must not have that, so quickly.
Everybody needs to wax their bottom.
OK, a bit of advice from Sal. Everybody needs to wax their bottoms. They do things differently up in Stoke, apparently.
I'm sorry.
I'm probably going to need to go last on the clear, guys.
Oh, fuck.
What are you dipping here now?
Transparent.
Come on, come on.
Do you want me to see the rim?
I really appreciate it.
This isn't great timekeeping. The bees would know better.
Oh, my God.
Do you want me to clean the rim?
Just grab my box.
We are in the last minute now.
Which one's your bench?
That one. I need to put it on your board.
Thank you, love.
Oh, my God.
Cheers, guys.
Well done. Such great work. Congratulations.
Oh, my God.
The potters must now take their finished work to Rose for the final firing.
Can I do a little prayer?
The next time they will see their cheese sets will be when they're revealed in front of the judges.
I hope they can have blue, white and yellow, how I wanted them to be. Not the grey colour smear.
I think I probably overstretched what I could do in the time.
I honestly feel as though every second of every minute I used.
Time management would obviously be something I would really have to look at.
I've got everything finished. I got everything, the colours that I want them to be, and I hope to God that none of it sticks together in the firing.
It's Judgment Day. The cheese sets have had their final 24-hour firing at 1,000 degrees centigrade, and there is nothing more that the potters can do. They won't see their finished work until it's revealed to the judges.
Potters, well done on your first week. We have before us 12 cheese sets, and I'm sure you are as keen as us to see how they all turned out. So without further ado, Jodie, could you please bring your cheese set up for the judges?
Oh, yeah.
So how are you feeling, Jodie?
Nervous.
So am I.
Colours are a bit washed out.
Well, my initial thoughts are... You've done really well.
Oh, really?
Really. The cheese dome is a perfect size. Feel the weight of that. It's brilliant.
It's lovely. Beautifully
Absolutely
made.
Brilliant. I love the fact that when you lift up the cheese dome and you see the road there.
Technically speaking, the make is fantastic. The lids couldn't fit any better. The pickle jars to the cheese dome to the pan. And in terms of the proportion, they're bang on. I was really worried that the design might just look flat because you hadn't brought any other texture into it. But the way you've sprayed it on just creates real depth in the stencils. You've got that hard edge, you've got the softness of the spray. I think it's really effective. It works really beautifully.
Really, well done, Jodie.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Great.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm speechless. Very blue. I love the leaves.
That blue colour really, really works for you. You've managed to get some definition on the leaf. This is an accent. It works really well. It's nice and consistent.
Where the glaze is on some of the very ends of some of the petals, it's a bit sharp. And I was worried it might feel a bit delicate. But yeah, actually, no, it feels like it handles the weight of the dome.
It's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. It was all about the waves hitting the rocks.
The cheese dome's a bit small, but this works really well. I'm loving the facets.
It's a lovely contrast between the glaze and the texture. It does sort of feel like it's a rock.
Carved it with my spoon.
Your magic spoon's done you proud. As a set, it seems to work really, really well, doesn't it?
Thank you.
I would have liked to have seen a bit more sparkle, a bit more of that sort of night sky.
Yeah.
I love the barnacles. I just think they really tie everything together and they make it feel like it's of the sea.
This works really well. It's actually surprisingly nice to hold. A bit like you, Rich.
Wow.
You're quite surprisingly nice to hold.
Why, thank you.
Are you ready?
It would have been nice to get it finished.
And you did give yourself an awful lot of work, and obviously you had troubles in the make, which I think have sort of shown in some of these pieces.
The lid is stuck. That really won't come off. Let's take the centrepiece here. It's a bit on the heavy side.
But look at those illustrations. Yeah. This one's crying, so I think that must be...
You, Rich. Yeah. You.
Possibly.
This is Rich.
Rich the carbon boy.
Yeah.
And then, who's this?
Aphrodite, I think.
That was it. Venus.
You're obviously very, very talented with your illustration. This having the map underneath is absolutely brilliant.
It's an awful shame you didn't finish it. I think there's the makings of something that could have been really special.
These ladies aren't as elegant as I wanted.
Art Deco as a concept is quite precise, isn't it?
That's right.
And it's quite sharp.
There's an elegant woman in there somewhere waiting to get out. But I think the colours actually draw it together really nicely as a set.
I'm very disappointed because I had real trouble with the glaze. Yeah, it's completely fused.
The glaze has obviously really moved over that resist.
Absolutely.
And the pickle jars, again, the lid comes off this one, but we can't get the lid off that.
Again, it's run down.
Yeah. You've gone for a very simple look, and the simpler the look, if it doesn't work, it's like, oh, my God.
A bit nervous, because I think I took a bit too many risks in this one. But I had to... Oh, my God. Woo! It turned out gold. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, feeling
bad. Oh, love. This is absolutely brilliant.
It almost looks like metal. I mean, that's just so much pure oxide in the glaze. The way the light catches this is really quite beautiful.
Yeah.
You took a risk, not just with that, but you took a risk with squaring up the cheese dome. You're showing the real attributes of the material itself, that you can manipulate it into what you want. But obviously the elephant in the room here is the fact that we can't take the lids off the pickle jars.
But I really admire your ambition, because to come in here week one, take something from the wheel and make it into a completely different shape. I mean, it's a recipe for disaster, really, but you went for it.
Well done, Alan. Well done, well done.
Thank you.
Oh, it's all right, it's not too bad.
Your overall design is brought together by this yellow that's just coming through the whole lot, and it's faultless as a colour. It almost feels like liquid honey. The form is incredible. The fact that you've managed to get those lovely, soft, thrown lines right through everything, they're all straight-sided, perfectly matching pickle jars. They feel evenly thrown. I want to hold it. I can't emphasise enough how difficult it is to get that fluidity in the throwing.
Although this could have been a slightly taller, could have been slightly more generous with the cheese, please, next time. But I think that's taken away by the charm of it. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Outstanding set, really.
Well done.
Great,
Harry.
Thank you. OK?
I'm a bit nervous. It's just inspired by my granddad and tried to make a cheese set that I could picture being in his home.
So, should we have a look?
Yes. Oh, no.
I take it from that, you're not that impressed?
No. I didn't leave myself time to glaze, and I literally threw them in the bucket. So, there's no way that's coming off that plate.
Well, I mean, I would say...
Oh, no! It's a miracle!
There's that's one thing that is better than I thought. That's good.
And actually, Hannah, don't give yourself too much about. This is great. This reaction you've got here is absolutely brilliant. Pottery, it's a wonder, isn't it? You know.
I'm sorry.
We'll just cry together.
Yeah, I'll take over, shall I? You guys.
Honestly, no, you were going for that abstract painting. It's actually worked really, really well for you.
I just think it's got energy, it's got life about it. The fact that you've got different decoration on each part of your set, but it does really feel like it comes together as a coherent design, is really testament to your creativity and the application of the glazes.
So how are you feeling, Sal?
Oh, I'm nervous, terrified.
Should we have a look at Charlie?
Oh, yeah. Okay. And it's a little patchy, which is a bit of a disappointment.
It's brilliant, mate.
Thank you.
It's brilliant.
Thank you.
It's fantastic. You know, I haven't even picked it up yet, and it looks good. The definition of the dog there and the way that you've used those pigments is absolutely fantastic.
Just the way you've added different colours onto the surface and then you've put that transparent over the top and it's kind of sucked into all of that texture that you've put on. Yeah. It just makes it feel like fur.
The attention to detail in the sculptural knobs there is absolutely fantastic. You've even got little holes in the cheese.
You've not distorted or smudged any of the writing. It just looks like it's been written on with confidence.
And as for pickle jars, they're identical. They're sublime.
I mean, there is literally no element on this set that we can fault.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
Yeah, really lovely set.
Well done.
Thank you. Yeah, don't cry, I'll do it again. Yeah.
Well done.
Thank you.
A pleasure to look at.
Yeah.
Thanks, Keith. Thank you. When Keith cries, I cry. It's hard not to. He's so emotional about it, and I'm passionate about it, so the two of us are a terrible pair.
I just wish you could lift the dermis. At least it stuck together very uniformly.
Feeling pretty nervous just now. I think there's a really strong chance of me going home.
Keith and Rich must now decide who'll be our first Potter of the Week and who will be going home.
So that moment, it was absolutely amazing to see when the Hessian is pulled off the set and they get to see their set for the very first time. Their reactions were extraordinary.
It also just shows how passionate they are about what they've done.
Yeah.
And you've got to love that. It's absolutely brilliant.
So, Potter of the Week.
Well, I mean, Sal is certainly up there.
Sal won the poor chalices.
And her cheese set was just beautiful.
For me, another person up there is Jodie. She'd done that landscape with that road disappearing off into the distance. It was brilliant.
I've got to mention Lee's. The way he put those undulating surfaces into the forms, it just made you want to touch it. It was so tactile.
Well, as much fun as it is talking about all the potteries who've done well, unfortunately, a few didn't do as well.
Well, the big cheese dome in the room for me has got to be Ara.
He talked about the simplicity of design and how he wanted the glaze to really enhance that surface. And unfortunately, put it on way too thick and it just fused the whole thing together.
Is there anybody else who you think is in danger?
Suze, unfortunately.
Yeah.
There were little glimmers of absolute excellence, but that was meant to be across the whole set.
You now have a decision to make.
Yeah.
You need more tea?
Yeah, more tea, yeah.
Yeah, and we'll need more tea and biscuits.
Maybe a little bit of cheese.
Potters, well done on your first week in the pottery. Your cheese sets were magnificent. You're all winners to me, but unfortunately, I'm not a judge, which came as a bit of a surprise to me, I'm not going to lie. Firstly, the good news. This week's Potter of the Week is... Sal. Okay, now the really, really rubbish bit that I don't want to do, but I checked and contractually I have to do this. The potter who's going to leave us is... Ara. I'm so sorry,
oh,
Ara.
It's fine. No, honestly. Sorry. I'm being crushed here, by the way. I hate white glaze.
So much love to you, Ara.
Thank you, honestly.
Gutted. There's no point in ifs and buts and things. It just didn't work for me on the day.
In these sort of weird times, we're all in this bubble together.
Yeah.
And I do feel that we've created a bit of a family here.
Yeah.
And you are one of those members of the family.
Thank you.
I have no idea what's just happened. I'm Potter of the Week. I can't think of a word to do. Honestly, you've addled my brains.
talk to anybody who knows me, they'll say I've always got something to say, and I just can't think of anything.
Sal's Cheese Set is the first work that Rose will place in our throwdown gallery.
Oh, I'm chuffed with Sal. Every time I speak to her, I just want to grab a notepad because she's just got so much knowledge about pottery. So, yeah, well deserved.
I texted my husband yesterday and said, I'll see you. And I honestly thought I was out.
What's your plan? What's next for Susan?
Take over the world.
Next time. It's bricks and buildings.
Respect to the hand builders of the world.
A towering clay construction challenge.
Oh.
And a grueling spot test.
Come on, get your backs into it!
Will reveal which potter's foundations are about to collapse.
Yikes. Well, you can see that next week at the same time of 7:45. Well, salute them from your sofa. Our NHS heroes at St George's are back for a new series. 24 Hours in A&E begins Tuesday at 9. Putting her plans into place next tonight and recruiting her first cohort, stylish period drama, Elle Fanning and Nicholas Hoult in The Great.